Hello, I'm Andrew Fryer, and in part two of my look at server core and SQL Server Denali, I've got my server core installation set up here on a clean VM, but with no configuration. In order to configure, I could do endless command line stuff, netsh to set up the firewall, open ports, etc., dism to add roles and features, to the point where I could maybe remotely administer this machine. There is an easier way, and it's called Sconfig. And that's built into Windows Server 2008 R2 core. A very lightweight GUI here that you can see. And the first thing I want to do here is join it to a domain. Select domain. I'm going to join it to Contoso. I get asked for the credentials as you'd expect. And the password. I do want to change the name. I'll call it Denali Core 1. Unfortunately, I have to put all this in again. And now I can restart the computer. Now I can join that domain. And run sconfig again. The other thing I might want to do is configure remote management. I'm going to allow MMC remote management. Enable Windows PowerShell. So what that's done is enabled Windows PowerShell by using dism for us. Just going to run that sconfig one more time, just to complete the remote management settings. I'm going to allow server remote management. And that's me pretty much done with this particular console. There is another way of doing this. And that is to use something called core configuration, which is a utility that you can download from codeplex. So I've put the URL up here if you want to do that. And I've already pulled that down as an ISO file, and now I can mount that on here. If I now go to my E drive and have a look at it, you can see there's a WSF file, and that's the one I want to use to get the console up. You don't actually have to do any installation, but it will check that all the prereqs are there before it runs the tool. And we'll see that in a minute. And it's also asking me to accept the audience participation program. And once I've done that, I'm now ready to start using server core. And I can do all sorts of clever things in here. I can go to control panel settings. I can look at the firewall. I can add drivers, add remove programs, regional settings, set Windows update, and so on. I can also add roles and features from here. I can just go down this list, and there's a couple I need for SQL Server Denali, so I'm going to get those ready now. And essentially, that's just more of the .NET framework. The .NET framework 2 on x86, and the .NET framework on x64 and x86. So I can apply those. And behind the scenes, it's all running PowerShell scripts, so there's not too much extra weight to using this tool. And indeed, we haven't installed it. You can see the scripts coming up at the bottom of the screen here. So that's that done. I can also configure remote desktop here, so I can get to this machine from other machines. I can have a look at services. I can also do, as you can see, the computer domain and so on here as well. So that's a quick look at configuring Windows Server Core. And in part 3, we'll get on to the serious business of installing SQL Server.